People, and welcome back to the happiest cast on earth, the show where we review every single film that was released, bought out, or made by the Walt Disney Company in alphabetical order. We are back, baby,
after a nearly business practices.
Yes, after nearly 4 month hiatus, the happiest cast on earth is back looking at a bunch of really, really crappy Disney movies. And today is going to be no exception. By the way, I'm here once again with my friend Andrew because he has no life, apparently. And today, we are going to be taking a look at the 2010 Disney Channel movie, 16 Wishes. Now, Andrew, have you seen this movie before?
No.
Well, here's a little bit of a fun fact.
And I do not intend to.
Then why the frick did you agree to do this episode?
Coercion.
Well, here's a little bit of a fun fact for you, Andrew, and for the people at home. This is the first movie on the Happiest Cast on Earth that I have seen before this recording this episode.
History
in the making, folks. I actually saw this back in the day when it initially aired on Disney Channel, and I only remember two things from it. One, the premise and the tagline of the movie, which was a girl on her 16th birthday gets 16 candles, and she makes a wish on each of them, and that wish comes true on the spot. And the tagline was, be careful what you wish for, something like that. The other thing I remember that she had a brother who played this fake guitar, like toy guitar. And I think by the end of the movie, she gave him, damn it. And I think by the end of the movie, she gave him an actual guitar. Oh, and Debbie Ryan from Suite Life on Deck was in it. Yeah, that's all I remember.
Yeah. Now, you know what I remember about it?
What?
Nothing, because I haven't seen it yet.
Yes. Although, technically, now, a little bit of a fun fact about this movie is that Disney wasn't the sole distributor of the film. See, this movie aired on Disney Channel in the U.S., but in other parts of the world, specifically Canada, it aired on Family Channel. Now whether it aired on Disney Channel or the Family Channel at other parts of the world, that I was not able to find in my research, but it didn't just solely air on Disney Channel. In fact, this film isn't even listed as part of the Disney Channel original movies lineup, despite the fact that the main star is a Disney Channel actress.
Who?
Debbie Ryan. She was in a Disney show's Suite Life on Deck and Jessie.
You already mentioned that, didn't you?
Yes, I did, like 2 minutes ago.
Sorry.
Yes. I'm pretty sure that even Duke would pay better attention than that, but here we are.
Yeah.
So.
I go brain dead sometimes for no reason.
You know, I could have delayed this episode even further for so this would drop on my birthday, but we don't like that. I don't want to make this a 5 month hiatus. That would just suck. Who would do that? No.
Although it would be, you could, you know, use it as like a marketing strategy or something.
What? For what?
You could say, like this video and subscribe because it's my birthday or something like that.
My birthday's in June.
Well, yeah, but like if it was, if we did do it in June, whatever, just let's move on.
I mean, is it your birthday?
No.
Is it your birthday month?
No.
What's your birthday month?
You were there.
Was it August? It was August.
Yes.
My bad.
Whatever.
But anyway, enough stalling. Sadly, we're going to have to watch our first Disney Channel movie on the happiest cast on Earth. Andrew's walking away.
No, I'm not.
And we will be right back with our thoughts on 16 Wishes on the happiest cast on Earth. Okay, alright, before we actually get to the review, we just made a revelation. Andrew did not like Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
It sucked, man.
Can you explain that? Can you explain that?
Okay. My first reason is Carly. She's the worst villain ever. Her goals and her motivations are awful. And like it seems like the writers were conflicted about what you should feel for her.
I mean, I don't think anybody really liked Carly as a good villain, but...
Well, yeah, but that's just one reason why the show is terrible.
Many people viewed like John Walker as like the real villain, even though he wasn't technically the villain of the show, but...
I mean, he was all right. He's probably the best developed character. He went through the most character development.
He went through a decent story arc. We'll admit that.
Yeah, but here's the thing: whenever he gets redeemed at the end, it doesn't feel like there's no reason for him to be redeemed, and there's like nothing happened.
Like he went from crazy, I'm gonna kill you, to I gotta save the
laughing heroic guy. Yeah,
He went from Homelander to Superman in like 5 seconds.
Exactly. So back to Carly, she's like the worst villain. So whenever she explains why she's doing this, because like the world is, you know, not as unified as it was during the 5-year blip, they're trying to make you feel for her. But like throughout the entire show, she shows time and time again that she's a bad person and that her logic is wrong. Well, and also,
the show states that that her goal, her message is decent. What she wants to do is okay. Even Sam says that. But the way that the Flag Smashers are doing it, that's the stoop. That's what's wrong. That's what they don't like.
Yeah, the way that they're doing it is terrible, and it doesn't make any sense why they would go about it.
Yeah, even the characters in the show think that's intentional on the show's parts, though.
Well, no, but like they're killing people. That's what they're talking about. They're talking about what makes her wrong. I'm talking about what makes her stupid. During the climax, they intend to like somehow unify the world by attacking some UN board meeting and holding hostages and stuff. And all I could think when watching that scene was, that is stupid. Her goal is unaccomplishable.
Really? Really?
Yes, the world can't be, like, you know, unified like that. The only way that they were was during the blip, which was like a universe-wide tragedy.
Well, if that is all the criticism that you have against the Falcon and the Winter Soldier right now, then you can go ahead and get out of here, because Falcon and the Winter Soldier is a fantastic series. Which is better, that or WandaVision?
WandaVision is better.
Yeah, even I think WandaVision was kind of better.
Yeah, it has more class, it's fun, it's, you know, it's interesting.
It has the mom from that 70s show.
From what show?
That 70s show. Anyway, back to the show. Okay, we just saw 16 Wishes. That sucked.
Meme review.
This was not a meme, even if we wanted it to be. Review.
This movie is so bad, it's probably meme worthy.
Like, there were several parts throughout the movie that just made me go, why would you do that? Everything in this is horrible. What logic does this apply to? So, yes, the film is about a girl named Abby who it's her 16th birthday party, and for like 8 freaking years, she was compiling a list of 16 things she wanted to do on her 16th birthday. One of them was like sushi for some reason, and like, seriously, who?
I actually made a list of like the wishes that she made and the order that she made them, so I can push this
in the movie or on the list.
No, not on the list. They're the ones she actually did. She didn't do all of them, did she?
No, she didn't do all of them. Some of them are just.
No. She only did
like the sushi one. Like, they only did like half
did
of the 10 wishes.
Of them.
Only 10?
Yeah, here, I'll put it up here.
Read them off.
All right, I'll read them off. So, the first one was to meet some sort of pop star that she had a crush on for a really long time.
Who, for second the sake, one we'll was just say the Jonas Brothers.
Yeah. The second one was to get a red sports car.
It's not even that nice of a car, really.
Yeah, it's not. She could have done so much more with that.
The car looks just as good as my sister's car.
Yeah, it's not. It's fine. It's not.
Not like, oh my god, you guys.
The third one was that she wished to have the cutest clothes, even though that's a matter of opinion.
They're not even that cute, really. They're in just school, fun. They're just is. Generic high school popular girl clothes.
Yeah.
What's so special about them?
They're special because they're...
They're special because the movie says they are.
Yes. The fourth one was to beat Krista, which this other girl, it's like this other girl that hates her.
Her rivals in the third grade.
Yeah.
And the reason they're rivals is because Abby stole her best friend when she moved. Abby kind of sucks. She's really selfish for the grand majority of the movie. She's annoyingly selfish. Granted, the movie kind of acknowledges that she's selfish, but she's an annoying protagonist.
More so towards the end, like in the beginning, they acknowledge
she
that.
She is annoying. Like, yeah, it mostly has to do with her, mainly her writing and Debbie Ryan's performance. Oh God, that's obnoxious. I do not like that. Continue on with your list.
All right. Yeah, she wanted to beat Krista, and they play a volleyball game, and Krista gets knocked out because it hit her in the head.
She intentionally injured a person.
And the lesson is, if someone is causing you trouble,
just hit him in the head with a volleyball.
And being mean to you.
Yeah, just hit him in the head.
Instead of ignoring them, hit them with a volleyball in the head, causing severe brain hemorrhaging and some other injury possible.
Violence, the answer to all solutions.
Yes.
Well, the answer to all problems. I pretty much just said the violence with the answer to all answers.
Yeah. Her fifth one was to be popular, which is, it's kind of a pretty generic.
Like what is she popular for? She's not a cheerleader. She's not in the football team. She's just popular also, because she's popular.
She didn't wish this other one, but it was on her list that she was going to like. On her list to like wish for this boy to like her.
I don't even remember. I don't think he even has like a single line of dialogue, to be honest. Well, yeah, he does, but there's like two lines of dialogue. I don't remember his name. I'm just gonna call him generic hot
white guy.
Generic hot white guy. Yeah, that's who he is.
But okay, so here's the thing. Whenever she wishes for the whole popularity thing, she kind of thinks that it's okay. She thinks it's fine to do that, but the reason she doesn't wish for this boy to like her is because she would think that that's unnatural, despite the fact that she's already won the approval of several people.
She had the entire school process. She had the entire school love her for doing literally nothing, yet wishing for one other person to be her boyfriend. Oh, that's unnatural. I need to make him like me over time.
And that's called a double standard.
Yes. My God. I believe the next wish she did was the big one that she did. I wish to be treated like a grown-up.
Well, actually, it's her driver's license.
Oh, my bad.
It took her, like, how many wishes?
I forgot about the driver's license.
It took her, like, 3 wishes to actually realize that she couldn't drive the car and that she needed her license.
Well, actually, she figured that out as soon as she got the car.
But yeah, she figured it out, but she didn't act on it.
And, you know, let's talk about her fairy godmother. So, there's this...
it's a Disney trope.
So we have this, birthday fairy, as she called it, whose name is, crap, what's her name?
Celeste, I think.
Celeste, and she has these magic, she has this magic...
She has these magic, cigars. She's these magic doobies. These magic,
magic matches and magic, magic candles. And it's never explained. It's never explained where she comes from, why or how she has the magic candles, why she even wants to make Abby's birthday special or to teach her a lesson. She's just there to give her a happy birthday and to teach her a lesson of not being selfish. You need to explain these things. Like, if you're gonna have a movie with magic and magical rules, you need to explain them so the audience isn't going, wait, what, how, wait?
Speaking of the magical rules, they're so weird and inconsistent.
Okay, so the rules are...
even the characters struggle with what the rules are.
Okay, so the rules for making wishes is that you could only make one wish an hour, even if you make a wish at like 8:55 or 5, and the next wish is like 9 o'clock. Since they're in separate hours, they count. So, yeah.
Wait, that's how it works?
Yeah, that's how the movie explains it. It's not like every single hour you get a wish. It's within the hour, not every single hour that goes by. That's how she was able to wish a...
Not on a cooldown, per se.
That's how she was able to wish to meet the pop star and to get a car within minutes and how what and there's also why when she tries to use her magic again, it backfires and doesn't work.
Yeah. Okay. Also, the magic in the world, it does the magic and her wishes and stuff affect a lot of stuff. Like it changes entire backstories between her and her friends and her enemies too, and stuff like that. So it's implied that all of these wishes affect literally, they affect everybody basically.
Like when the pop star shows
up, like that.
When the pop star shows up out of nowhere, like what is that? No,
but like whenever she meets up with her best friend, there's this boy that he's her typical best friend, and they always hang out. But whenever she wishes for something to, whenever she reaches some sort of history changing, life changing wish. Thing, and she's in the aftermath of that, and he doesn't remember her. All it takes is for her to like show him a little broken heart necklace.
Well, put it together. We're getting ahead of ourselves. We've neglected to mention the wish that she wishes to be treated like she a grown up.
Let's get the other wishes.
Yes, so...
A driver's license. Her seventh wish is for people to stop treating her like a kid.
And that's
the wish.
And she ends up getting... Literally turns into an adult. And, like, she becomes 22. And she's and nobody remembers her from high school. And her parents and everybody that she meets... treats her like an adult, because technically she is an adult, which, hey, now you can smoke weed, drink beer, and be in porn, so hey, that's cool.
Can we get taken down for that?
Nope.
Okay.
See, you can talk about porn on YouTube, you just can't show porn.
All right.
But she doesn't want this stupid adult life and miss graduation. And it took her like 10 minutes to figure out that, oh crap, they stretched my wish out. They took it the wrong way.
They don't recognize her as who she was.
Like it took her till after her friend didn't recognize her. It took her till teachers were treating her like an adult, till her parents made her move out. It finally took her to where she saw a photo of graduation, be like, oh wow, the witch made me a literal adult. Like, is she stupid and selfish?
She is stupid.
Everyone in this movie is stupid.
Yeah.
You have the brother with the fake guitar going.
They don't know how to do deductions. They're not.
Huh?
Hmm? They can't put two and two together. They're dumb.
During the gym scene, there was this one dude with a volleyball or basketball, or whatever, and he had it up his shirt, pretending he was pregnant, or whatever. Like, who does that after their...
Wait, there was someone who was pretending to be pregnant?
Yeah, there was some dude in the background pretending to be pregnant with a volleyball. Like, who does that after the age of 9?
I mean...
These guys are supposed to be in high
school. I'm not
going to
talk here.
You still do it, do you?
No, still do it. I don't do that because I don't play volleyball.
But do you deal with a basketball?
So her eighth wish, and this one just comes from like a desire to summon the godmother person. It's just decorating her room the way she wants it to be. That's the wish. It only serves to summon the fairy godmother. That's it.
And, it's not important. And the fairy godmother pretty much tells her, "Hey, you can't wish for something that's not on the board, you dummy." I just bumped the mic. Oh, no.
This next one comes from, like, she tries to erase it and turn it. Does she try to turn this? It's the sushi one. Does she try to turn it into something else?
It's the sushi one, yes.
She tries to turn it into something else.
Yeah, but it's magic, so you can't erase it or whatever.
She says that she hates sushi. That's it.
That's I hate sushi.
She probably wrote this one when she was 5 or something.
Yeah. Even the characters acknowledge that's a stupid wish. To wish to like sushi. Nobody freaking likes sushi. Like, I don't mind decent Chinese food or some decent fish, but who actually likes sushi, unironically?
I know some people. I think it's freaking disgusting, but I know some people who do. I've only eaten sushi once, and I hated it.
To be honest, I don't think I've ever actually tried sushi, but I've heard the horror stories about it. And I don't think I want to try it.
Yeah.
So, her next wish was to wish that her parents would understand her, and she does this to maybe think that they'll believe her on the whole magic candles thing, but no, they just understand her how she hates being an adult, and they just give her lesson, be like
some cookie cutter speech about how growing up is different from how she imagined it.
Yeah, basically being a grown up, the big message of this movie is to, well, this movie technically really has two wishes. Number one is which is also the tagline of the movie from the commercials, be careful what you wish,
right? The two messages.
Number one is be careful what you wish for, pretty much, because
Like Mr. Limpet.
Yeah, the Don Knotts cartoon fish movie, The Incredible Mr. Limpet. For some reason, Andrew brought that up.
Because it's a great film.
I only watched that once when I was like 9 or whatever. I found the DVD at a dollar store, and I only bought it because it had
it's a great film.
I only bought it because it had cartoons of real people on it. You know, I only saw one YouTube video that even referenced it, so...
Well, that doesn't mean it's not a good film.
I mean, I haven't seen it in years, so... Maybe it's good, maybe it isn't, but... I don't know. Maybe when we look at it again for this podcast, we'd know for sure.
Except we got to get all the way out of the numbers into the T.
Except for the fact that The Incredible Mr. Limpet isn't a Disney movie, so I just fooled you. So anyway, So her rival is having her 16th birthday party, and that's not a middle finger. That is not.
No, because I'm a good boy. I don't do that.
If you're a good boy, then why are you on my show?
Because I'm not. That was a lie.
So anyway, her rival is having her 16th birthday party, which looks cool, and
they have the same birthday, by the way.
Yeah, they have the same birthday. We've neglected to mention that. We've also neglected to mention that her house is being fumigated because of a wasp.
Oh, bees! That's the stupidest thing ever.
Not wasps, but bees. Bees are hornets.
No, it's wasps. I'm pretty sure.
A wasp nest.
It's just a bunch of bees. Whatever.
Yeah. Why do gotta be bees? The bees. They're in my eyes. Ah, not the bees.
Bees.
Not the bees, not the bees. Not there in my eye. So anyway, the guy that she likes notices her car and he wants a picture with it. And he's also dating her rival. And she realizes that her brother can't actually play guitar. And she manages to jog her best friend's memory back by showing him her best friend's necklace. And that's how the rules work, I guess.
Yep. Inconsistent magic.
Oh my god. Like, we're almost done describing this piece.
And he also seems to have knowledge about, like, about all the wishes that she's made.
I mean, it jogged his memory back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then,
the rules don't really have to be too sorted out because it's like this one movie. It's not an entire franchise. But it would have made more. But it would have been fine if they just added some.
When you have a magical world or a world that has magic in it, you have to explain how it works. You can't just say, have everything go, oh, it's magic, don't question it. You have to explain how the world works. That was some of the criticisms that Frozen had initially, until the second one came in and fixed it all.
Wait, people were having questions?
People had questions on how Elsa had her ice powers. That's pretty
much it. Oh, yeah. Like,
then Frozen 2 came out 6 years later and answered those questions. Like, oh, she's a living element.
You don't always need to give, you don't always need to explain magic, like the interworkings of magic, because that sometimes...
Yeah, that small little... There's a suspension of disbelief that there's a line that can only be crossed ever so slightly. Stuff like Frozen, where it's just like, oh, Elsa has her powers because it's magic. That's acceptable. But this movie crosses.
Yeah, but when the magic is inconsistent like this, it doesn't follow its own rules.
Like, say, they set up rules and they don't follow them at all. Maybe also comment that the one wished hour thing never gets brought up again in the movie. So it's entirely pointless. Like, oh my god.
What time did you go to school?
I don't... way too freaking late for it to be high school. Because it was still daylight outside. God, I wish high school was that freaking late in the morning.
So maybe like 8 a.m.?
It was like... They mentioned that it was like 9 a.m.
God,
how I wish I got up at 9 a.m. to go to high school. That's a freaking blessing. I mean, now I'm homeschooled, so I can wake up whenever I want for school. But still, when I actually went to public school, that would have been nice to not wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning to go to school.
Okay, that's okay. The wish is that if she had made one wish every hour, it would have been like 1 minute. I mean, it would have been 8 p.m. So that's all right.
Okay. So, oh my god. And apparently, this film is a reverse It's a Wonderful Life, where in It's a Wonderful Life, everyone's worse off without Jimmy Stewart being born. However, in this film, everyone is apparently better off that our main character, Abby, was born a couple years earlier.
Yeah.
Like her brother
she's
can
a
play...
She's actually a plague on society.
Yeah. Like her brother's good at guitar, her rival's not mean, her friend is student body president. Like, yeah, everyone's better off if she never existed, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The plague on society.
Yeah, she could go die in a ditch for all we care.
Yes. It's a sad thought, but it's true.
And she gets to her home, and she finally realized that she could just take off the picture of her crush and write down, "I wish I could be 16 again," or something like that.
Yeah,
but she replaces a picture of herself from her 16th birthday.
She didn't write any. Yeah, she just put a picture down.
Because apparently it doesn't recognize gum, but she then puts a picture of herself on the paper with gum, and this time it does recognize it, but...
And that's their explanation, and it makes no sense.
What? Oh,
what does the gum have to do with it?
Why didn't she just write it down? I think it's because you could easily take the gum, take the picture off and throw it away or whatever. Where with the, everything else,
she couldn't have planned for this eventuality.
Yeah, no one could predict it. So she wishes to do the whole thing over again, and she does everything good again. She learns why her rival's been such a jerk. The wasps were taken care of. She gives her brother a guitar. Well, the money for a guitar. And
it ends at this.
And this movie was stupid predictable the entire way through. Like, from the moment I saw her best friend, I knew that they were going to get together in the end. Because for some reason, in media, specifically kids media, like crappy live action kids media, they don't think that male-female friendships exist. Like, what the frick? For some reason, in media, they don't think that a friendship between a heterosexual male and a heterosexual female exists. Like, have you ever noticed that in media? It's always, they're best friends, but one of them secretly has a crush on the other one, and they become boyfriend-girlfriend. But uh-oh, one of them has a crush on this other guy. It's always that type of stuff in crappy kids media. It always, like, my God.
Yeah.
The movie ends with them getting together and having a big 16th birthday party. My God, this movie.
Also, at the end, she kind of makes up with her rival and asks her why things are so rough in between them.
Yeah,
and
because I mentioned that earlier, it's because she stole her best friend.
She stole her best friend in the third grade. But
crap, I forgot to mention the other moral this movie gives us.
After Abby, that's the name of the main character. After she apologizes or something, she
becomes less selfish.
No, they become friends. And as unlikely as it is that someone would make a lifelong commitment based on somebody stealing your friend in the third grade.
Wait, who the frick is still friends with people that are friends in third grade?
If you did make that kind of lifelong commitment, why would you just throw it away because someone apologized?
I mean, an apology can go a long way.
I know, but it's like,
I mean,
but it wasn't even like a real apology either.
I mean, she realized that she took her friend away, and I guess she felt bad. I don't know.
That's pretty much all my problems with the film.
And
sucks.
The acting. Oh my God, the acting. Everyone overacts or underacts. Well, particularly the main dude, like Debbie Ryan's best friend, like I feel like he can do a bit of underacting sometimes.
I don't know.
A big old blend of under and overacting.
I think Debbie the acting Ryan, was fine, but but it's only fine because it demands so little of them.
Editing is annoying. It's very early 2000s, but this movie came out in 2010, so I don't know what their excuse is. There's a lot of fast paced repeating shots, like they repeat the same shot like three times in a row. Weird close-ups and zooms. very fast-paced editing, which gets old very, very fast. And the soundtrack is full of nothing but just crappy pop songs that you're gonna forget immediately after you hear them.
Disney Channel crap, that's all you need to know.
But Disney Channel didn't make this, they just aired it. So, I don't know, like, so no wonder Disney Channel decided to air this. It fits exactly in with their types of crappy movies. Like you, I would see this in the list of Disney Channel original movies, and it would not surprise me. Like, it fits so well. It's surprising to me that Disney Channel didn't actually make this. They just aired it. It's super surprising, really. Like, baffling. So, I believe we said just about all we had to say about 16 Wishes. Andrew, I probably don't need to ask you this, but would you give this a golden castle or a giant Pooh Bear?
Pooh Bear.
Yep.
I would also give a giant Pooh Bear to Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
Oh my god. Yeah, this man doesn't like Falcon the Winter Soldier for some reason.
I hate it.
You give it a giant Pooh Bear.
It could have been so much better.
It was. You look at
me. It's not so much better. It was.
You look me right in the eye and tell me that Sam's Captain America suit doesn't look awesome.
Sam's Captain America suit looks terrible because the white on top just looks a bit.
That is a good
actually,
costume.
I'm just kidding. It looks fine.
Yeah, that is a good costume, and you know
it's a good costume, but that doesn't mean that the writing is good.
So, Andrew, do you have anything you'd like to plug?
My phone, because it's at 13%.
All right. So, if you guys did enjoy this episode, please, please leave a like and comment. And leave something in the comments to let me know what you thought. Also, be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified of when new episodes will be uploaded. And check out all the other crappy videos on the channel if you guys are interested in that type of stuff. Be sure to join me next time where we are going to take a look at the Touchstone Pictures early 2000s film starring Edward Norton, The 25th Hour. I know absolutely nothing about the movie, so it's going to be interesting to watch. And I hope it's actually a golden castle, because this is like episode 8, and we've only had 2 golden castles. There was...
Which one?
There was 3, the Dale Earnhardt story, and ESPN movie, and 10 Things I Hate About You.
And I wasn't even on those.
Yeah, I made you watch all the bad stuff. Anyway, guys, I'll see you later. Bye!